Alright, installing the fourth piston. Very last one. I got the thing lubed up. I got the rings compressed inside this tool right here. Go ahead and make sure it's yeah, it's pretty tight. Okay. This is the cringy part. So you have to make sure this is pretty straight. The crank lobe is at the bottom for this. And then you just hold this down and like that. And then very carefully feel this out down here, make sure it doesn't get marred. Make sure it centers itself. Okay. Just like that. You can see it's on there. Sure it's seated all the way. And then here's the rod cap itself. It is directional. So I have to make sure the halves are on there right. And then these bolts comes with this special lube. You're supposed to put the lube under the head. On the threads, otherwise you won't get the right torque value when you tighten these down. See? That stuff's so sticky, man. Every time I touch it, I gotta throw a pair of gloves away. Got to be tight and like just perfectly together. And then, first torque spec. Should be 25 pounds. Plus 55 degrees, so okay, and then we could do the 55 degrees. So in order to do that, hook up this torque angle gauge. Ooh. spin as we put things in here. So you hook that up. Zero. So what you do is you set this to zero, and then this little needle, here's what I like to do, I like to put a little preload on there so I know I'm right at 55, or I'm right on zero anyway. And then, ooh, wow, this is going to be challenging, huh? This is going to want to move. Oh, maybe hold it. Tight. That one here. Let's see. Zero. I think if I push towards the front of the block, it doesn't spin. Still holding it though. 55. Probably do it this way that way you can see it. Okay, well, the pistons are permanently in there. We can turn this by hand. Feels nice and smooth. That's a good sign. Let's see. Center one. All right, that's it. All the pistons are installed.